Hello my friends of Atari Labs, welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial is a basic tutorial. This is the tutorial that you have to do in order that you might consider using Python as a processing language to manage precipitation data. Okay, this tutorial is actually pretty basic. It's pretty basic for the purpose of analyzing precipitation data. I strongly recommend that you follow the tutorial, that you complete the example, the exercise, because you after the completion you will have a better sense of what can you do with Python for the management and representation of precipitation data or any hydrological data in Python. Okay, so let's start. You will receive this folder on the description of your video. So I have a Jupyter notebook. I will fill this. I will use Anaconda 3.7. Okay, I use Jupyter Notebook. I strongly recommend that you put that on your documents. Okay, and then once you have it on your document, you go to your documents and then you have a statistics interpretation. Okay, you have two folders here. The first one is the CSV, because you will have a CSV that is the precipitation data on a CSV file. With Python Pandas, you can work easily with Excel, TXT, CSV, and other formats, and is pretty stable. Here you have precipitation data from the 1998 to the 2007. Okay, great. Okay, and on the scripts is where we are going to locate our tutorial. So we create a new notebook, and this will be tutorial. Okay, great. So we are going to import the required library. So we create we are going to import the required libraries. The first library is an interactive mode, that is Matplotlib inline, that we bring the plot after the cells. So this is a cell in Jupyter Notebook. So after this, you will have, we run a kernel of Python 3. We are going to work with Pandas, with NumPy, with SciPy, okay, and with Matplotlib. Okay, Pandas is the one that opens the Excel file. NumPy brings some, let me check if actually, yeah, give us some, in this case we use it to make it arrays and to do filtering. Okay, on the SciPy there is some mathematical tools there, and on PyPlot is to create and to customize the representation. Okay, so we run it. Okay, great. What else we are going to do? We are going to read the CSV. Okay, we are going to read the CSV, and the CSV goes to the folder, it goes one folder up to precipitation more open, and the index is zero. Why the index is zero? Because the index is the date. The date will be the index. Okay, and there is a beautiful command here that says parse date true. That means that it will understand that this is a date. Okay, okay, and this is amazing, because it's understand that this is a date, because actually you have not defined this as a date. Okay, and then we can, with this, we can plot our data, and this, and that's it. So we have data for almost 20 years, and we plot it with just two lines. Okay, great. Then we are going to create a histogram of the precipitation values. Look, if we plot the histogram of the precipitation values, we see that the days without precipitations are the one that rules the histogram. Okay, so because these are all the days that have zero precipitation. So in order to create our hydrological distribution, so we are going to filter this data for the data that is precipitation. I mean, the data that has precipitated. I don't know how is on the deep mathematical formulation, if what I'm doing is kindly of legal, but in order to fit to in order to fit to a hydrological distribution, like there is no hydrological distribution that actually do this. Okay. Because it's actually everything will be skewed to the zero. I mean, to understand and to represent if there was precipitation or there wasn't precipitation. Okay. Great. So I create this and then I filter for the data that is above zero, and then I create this and then I run it, and this is a histogram, and this histogram is actually the values with precipitation. Okay, right. And then we have we are going to compare this histogram to the we are going to compare this histogram to an to two distribution, the normal distribution and the log normal distribution. Okay, so here we run it. Okay, and then this is the average and this is the standard deviation. Okay, and then by using some of the tools of SciPy, this is SciPy, we create a probabilistic distribution function of the normal distribution and the Pearson tree, that is the log normal distribution. Okay, so we run it. Okay, and then we can plot our data together, I mean our probabilistic distribution with the data, and to see which is the from the normal and the log normal, how is this related to the distribution. And then we see that the log normal distribution and the normal distribution are far from fit our distribution, our data, precipitation data, are really far from this. And this why? Because if you go to the mean and the standard deviation, those actually are related to the arithmetic average. Okay, the average is an arithmetic average where the outliers or the of the days with high precipitation has a lot of weight. Okay, those has a lot of weight in the distribution. Okay, that's why they skew, they create a lot of standard deviation. So in order to, we are going to filter, okay, because we are going to work just with the 80% of the values, in order to filter these outliers, and in order to decrease them from to have to have such a strong weight on the distribution. So with this, this is the 80, this is the 80 percentile, this is a precipitation 8.43, and then we create a cut, we create a filter of the data. Okay, great. Okay, and then once again we plot our data, so we create, we calculate the average and the deviation and create our normal distribution, log normal distribution. But for this clip set of from the this cut set of data, and then I run it, and then I plot it, okay, together with the histogram. Okay, the histogram, if you see, is norm. It's norm. It's norm, but in density true. Can be in density true. Okay, so if we run it, we have this, and this is a distribution of the precipitation along with the, this is the distribution of the precipitation along with the this is the log normal distribution and this is the normal distribution. So if you see, the ones that fit better with the distribution is the log normal distribution, but as well the I can change the number of bins, so to 10, it also depends on that. Yeah, or I can tend it to 8, okay, as long as, okay, so you see that there is a better fit. There is it's kind of polemical which is the best fit, but we know, but from the from this distribution, like the log normal distribution, is a distribution that fits better to the observed value, to the precipitation values. Okay, so this is I strongly recommend that you follow this tutorial, because this tutorial is kind of entry to another tutorials or another tutorials that we have where we use Python more intensively. From the experience of people that write to our blog, they told me, I really want to do some process, but I don't know Python. And like, okay, I personally learned Python from a book, yeah, and I strongly recommend that you do so also as well. Like, you take a book or any book that give you an overview of Python, to do the loops, to do the arrays, or some NumPy as well. But this is the procedure. I mean, like, you can do a lot on water resources with Python. It's really a lot, but you have to take time in order to make you proficient in Python. Okay, and this is not entirely Python, because my intention is to do this, the same exercise, in Julia. Okay, so I will do this is in Python, but I will export this to Julia as well. And with Julia, this exercise will be much is just for you as well to understand Julia, because Julia is another software, it has another tools and it has another approach. So, and then if you follow the two of them, you can make the comparisons. Okay, great. So it was a pleasure to be with you in this tutorial. I strongly recommend that you follow this. If you like what we do, just give it a like to our YouTube channel. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel and share our posts through your social networks. My name is Saul Montoya from Lima, Peru. Have a great day and see you in another video. Bye bye. Bye.